So my absolute favorite part of the park no longer exists. I grew up in the Disneyland of the mid to late 70s, the early 80s, and Tom Sawyer's Island was my jam. I mean, I loved going straight over there first thing in the morning. I loved it as the sun was setting. For anybody who Any of my Disney Parks homies who are out there right now listening, who know what I'm talking about, it was a magical experience during the late 70s. And now it's closed, of course, because of, building Star Wars Land. Even before that, it hardly resembled the Tom Sawyer's Island that I grew up with, because that was a phenomenal adventure. Look it up on Yesterland, see what I'm talking about. It had tons of bridges and forts that you could climb up and run around in, and like giant Fort Wilderness. And it had live like dioramas of Daniel Boone and Davy Crockett and Andrew Jackson signing the treaty with the Native American. It was just so cool. It literally was like bringing the 1950s version of the Wild Frontier to life. And you could actually shoot guns from the different points of the fort.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah, I mean, there weren't bullets coming out of it, but it made the sound of a bullet shooting out of it. And I mean, I could spend hours there just like aiming the gun and shooting it at things, not to be violent, but because kids obviously love that. And nothing was actually being shot, no nothing happened, but you were shooting it. And they had a little grave site of all of the soldiers. And it wasn't quite as the epitaphs weren't humorous like the Haunted Mansion. They were just honoring the soldiers and trees that you could climb up into, which I did. I have pictures to prove it. And you could buy spicy, yummy hot cider and lemonade and sour pickles and
Sounds really good.
stuff like that. It was fantastic. And quite, especially to a little tot, it was quite large, and all the caves that you could climb in and out of. And then they did a reboot somewhere around when Pirates of the Caribbean really blew up, after the first movie, and they added Jack Sparrow to Pirates of the Caribbean. Then they changed a lot of Tom Sawyer Island to have a lot of pirate stuff. And that always bummed me out because it had nothing to do with the classic Frontierland. Like, what does Frontierland have to do with pirates? Nothing.
Exactly.
Nothing to do with pirates, but they were kind of maximizing on the synergy. And they closed a lot of Tom Sawyer Island and changed it a lot for that. And so it's just kind of diminished, and Fort Wilderness got shuttered after a fire broke out because it was all original wood covered by fiberglass and fire retardant paint. But then at a certain point, the wood burned down and they turned it just into a storage facility. So that was my absolute favorite part of the park, and it was beautiful.
I think that's the bummer that unfortunately a lot of us Disney fans have to go through, where things change basically, and it's like that's one thing that bums me out, because I tell my kids, like, you'll never experience that. Like I got on this ride because we have family pictures and videos when I was younger, when we go to Disney World. And they're like, we want to get on that. And it's like, you can't. It's not there no more. But you're right. I mean, there's just things definitely where, I mean, it's gonna be good still, but you're like, why can't you just leave it there? Like, just come on. But yeah, they're always changing something, and they're maximizing on what they have. So I can understand, but a little bummed. Definitely understand that.
Well, I think it would be great if they could keep a balance between some of the classic stuff that really was successful and that Walt built and that does not need to be changed because it's still holding up. You're not going to be able to replace a Tom Sawyer Island because it the original Imagineers and the quality and craftsmanship that went into the woodwork. Nobody does anymore. It's too expensive. And it was a place for little kids to really race around and parents could just sit on benches and chill and drink a coffee or a hot cocoa and let the kids completely have at it and know that they were safe because there were security guards, you know, dressed as Civil War soldiers all over the place. And it was a very, it was like camp, you know, it was like summer camp for kids. And you would take the raft over there and you could spend a few hours and the parents knew they didn't have to do very much.